merger graph and merger table, these are the tools are required for your minimization of a finite state machine. Okay, so finite state machine has to be minimum number of steps. So how to minimize number of steps to this? So you have a finite state machine, it has multiple states, and it has a finite state machine, it has a minimum number of steps. So if I have a 10 state machine, and if you have a 4 state machine, so the 6 states are extra there, and for making the 6 states in VLI circuit, there are lots of transistors and all these things, that is a shear wastage and space, heat, all these things. So it is always have to be minimized. So how to minimize? One method I have shown it to you, that is between the divide the classes. So you have a 10 classes, by looking at the classes itself, you can divide and conquer. So if you see that the 10 states, one state is accepting state and other 9 are not accepting state, so you just divide it into 2. Or you see the 2 states are accepting states, 2, 8, then you again divide the classes with excitation of input alphabet, say 0 and 1, whether it is going to the next stage, going to accepting state or not accepting state. So by this with one symbol excitation, you can divide your classes. Then you can see you cannot divide the more than 4 classes. Then these 4 classes, one class can consist 3, another class consists of 3, another class consists of 2 and 2. So these are the 3 classes you can combine to a single state. So that is a one kind of technique, minimization of technique. So there are other examples can be done by merger table and merger graph. Again, these are merger table and merger graph. It is very simple. It is as mechanical. You have to draw the states. Say if you have states A, B, C, D, E, you have draw the states A, B, C, D, E in horizontally, and E to E, D, F in the vertically. You make a cross, and if A cannot be F definitely. Say if accepting state cannot be starting, so you can put cross. So if the more number of crosses means these are distinguishable states. Some states can be merged. That is the thing is called merger table, and the same thing called merger graph is. So last few classes we have already covered little bit of finite state machine, then the non-deterministic finite state machine. We have seen the same power, and then we have covered little bit deterministic push down automata and non-deterministic push down automata, context free grammar, but we have not completed yet. But now we are quickly jumping to the Turing machine. Why it is? Because I always feel that it is better to go for interesting topic first, then what are the topics we have left, we will definitely cover those topics, like merger table, merger graph. It is required for minimization of states. Anyway, this is very interesting. Here no concept of stack is here. So the so powerful stack fails where? Say A to the power n, B to the power n, stack is excellent, because you can take your A into the stack, and whenever B is coming, you match A and good. Even the opening parenthesis grammar, stack is excellent. But whenever we came across a grammar, W hash W, your stack cannot do anything, because whenever you say a W consists of a string A triple B, say your W is a string, it consists of A triple B, and then comes your hash, then comes again A triple B. So you put A triple B, you push into the stack, in your last bottom pointer is A, then 3 B's, then midpoint indicator hash comes, so you throw that, then another A comes. Now how to match this A to the bottommost portion of the stack? So you have to pop, so that is not possible. Where to keep this? So this pushdown automata is failure, is totally failure for W hash W language or WW language. W hash W is a simpler language. You are giving hash as a midpoint, but WW is a more tougher language, because again a non-determinism comes. Where the hash comes? The computer always try to guess the hash is coming now, hash is coming now. It has a many version. It one version becomes successful, we know this, you have got it. Okay, this is the problem area that Turing can help it excellently, very trivially. Turing machine can handle your a to the power n, b to the power n, but a to the power n, b to the power n is best handled by Pushdown automata by Turing machine, and but W hash W can be handled by the Turing machine very good. So what is basically Turing machine? Whenever he thought it in 1936, it is a like a self paper strip, and these are the input alphabets 0, 1, or it can be A, B, C, D. This is input alphabet, and there is one blank symbol. I have not shown it. In some books, it is B hash. In Sifser's books, it is a plate concept. That is basically, that means a blank. Blank, and that is a tape alphabet. Along with this is the input alphabet, and there is another tape alphabet like your in your Pushdown machine. We have a gamma. Here also a concept of gamma. It is nothing but a input alphabet with blank symbol. Okay, we'll come, and the machine, the states are jumping. Say initial state is S1, or some books say Q0, and now this thing. And one interesting, this is also a finite state machine, but one interesting thing is there is one state or more state is in accepting states, and one state or more state in rejecting states. Okay, so it consists of accepting states and rejecting states. So whenever it goes to a rejecting states, you don't have to end the reach of the end of the string. That is unique thing about your finite state machine from Pushdown automata and all. So you have a finite state machine, you have accepting states and rejecting states. Rejecting state concept you don't have there in Pushdown automata. These are basically finite state machine, but if you can write program, this machine can be more powerful. We have seen it from 1950s and 60s. So that is the reason computer is becoming very, very powerful, and now computer is now in everywhere. Your mobile phone is computer is there, your headphone, your computer is there. Maybe your watch, your fitness watch, is a computer is there. It can track your pressure and all these things, SpO2, and sometimes, and all these things the computer is now. So, and this gives the power for computation, and all the market dynamics could be changed. This is the programmable portion that last class I have. This is programmable that last class I have covered, that a Turing machine is basically an ideal machine. It can solve all these problems. Now, this is my favorite diagram. I always bring this diagram. You can always say this much we have covered. Regular we have covered. Context free we have more or less covered. One thing I must tell you, from regular to context free, from regular grammar we are just saying whether it is accepting state or rejecting. In regular grammar we always say whether it is a accepting and rejecting. But whenever we come to the context-free grammar with a PDA, or better, our all programming language are nothing but a deterministic context-free grammar with unambiguous grammar. There we are interested only accepting and rejecting. Not we know it will be accepted, but we want more a parse tree. That is not there in regular grammar. Regular grammar parse tree is very easy to get it, and damn easy. And there is no unambiguity in there. In any regular grammar, parse tree is simple, and that is one and only one. Okay. But whenever you come to the deterministic context-free grammar, so whether the string is accepting or rejecting, okay, fine. If it is accepting, there are more we are interested that how this string is being generated from the start symbol. If this string can be generated from the start symbol from the top down approach, if we can find two different trees, then this grammar is not acceptable, because it is unambiguous. That is ambiguous grammar. We always try to get the parse tree. That whenever you got the parse tree, that is, then we can only say the meaning of the language. So accept and reject is the first stage. Then the next we are interesting about the meaning of the sentence. Meaning of the terminals will be clear to you whenever it will be to know the parse tree. Okay, we can get the parse tree from the top down approach, that is LL1 approach. And another approach will be, we take the string from the right hand side, we try to match the rule so that we can reach to the S. It looks tough for human being, it is looks tough, but for computer this is easy. So that is the difference between human thinking and computer thinking. Computer much more powerful in different areas, but human powerful in different areas. We are very good at top down parsing, but bottom up parsing, wherever we want reach the start symbol from the right hand side, and we have all the production rules with us, and we try to match the handle. Handle, I have told you what is handle. It is LR1 possibly. It is LR1. We look ahead only one symbol at a time, and we have to match the rightmost derivation from the left, from the rightmost derivation. Yes, right derivation, which can be achievable from S. So this is tough. It can also be done by a stack. That's great thing. That is a bottom-up parsing. That is LR1. We'll cover it in our, it is out of syllabus. We will cover it in our compiler design class. But it's interesting. Why the deterministic context-free grammar is interesting? But deterministic context-free has limitation. What are the limitations? Like this kind of grammar, like W hash W. A simple thing. You know the string is repeating. But it no PDA can decide it, no FSM cannot decide it. So there the Turing machine there. So that is the reason I have told you, in our all programming languages, there is always some part of the context sensitive part, that part should be there. It is not purely context free. There is some part which is not the powerfulness is context free grammar is not there. Like to understand W hash W grammar. Or WW grammar, or A to the power N, B to the power N, C to the power N grammar. These are all context-sensitive grammar. Context-sensitive grammar is useful, so it cannot be done by push-down automata. We need a linear-bounded automata. Linear-bounded automata, nothing but a Turing. Regular grammar is everything is O N. This is N is the number of terminals, and context-free grammar max limit is O N cube. But we make it a O N by clever technique. We can make it unique. And but here, whenever it is context sensitive, these are all undecidable NP complete. What is NP complete? Okay. So what is Turing machine? Turing machine, no stack. It is very, very interesting. And there's an infinite tape, and tape the input symbols are there. And this is the finite state machine. Some state are accepting and some state are not accepting. Two-way access. And one thing is it has a read head and write head. It can go left and right. Initially, first was called the input. At each point, the computation the machine sees can replace symbols, change state, and move the head header life. This is very important definition of Turing machine. Turing machine, the head can read here, and the next it can read the head, and the next state it cannot be here. Okay, that is the head must move. This head is read and write head. It might write, it might not write. Nobody will force you to write, but it must go right side one step or left side one step. It cannot be at one place. Okay, so it will be always there. Okay, then you might ask question. Say, sir, what might happen? It go dancing like this. It go right, left, for a continuous time. Okay, then we call Turing machine doesn't halt. When the Turing machine halts, then this state control machine will go to either accepting state or rejecting state. But it can happen whenever it go left, right, or any place left, right, for a continuous amount of time, and the machine doesn't go not accepting state or rejecting state. Say this is accepting state, this is rejecting, this is accepting, this is rejecting. It move around this state. These are not accepting, neither accepting nor rejecting. Then we call the Turing machine is looping. Turing machine doesn't halt. Turing machine cannot decide a problem. And fortunately, when the Turing machine cannot decide the problem, they are very tough classes. Then however big computer you have, you cannot solve those problems. The Turing machine, the ultimate test, a test. So that whether the machine we can solve any other machine other than quantum computing, I am not saying the quantum computing, still quantum computing is in studying phase, that's it. So Turing machine is a very simple machine. It is a think of as a mechanical toy by Alan Turing in 1936 and 37. He showed that the some initial portion of the code can be used to program the machine. Then this Turing will be changed. Then I am coming to the concept of universal Turing machine. So that this is your program. First you read the program part, then the machine, this finite state machine is intelligent, then the data part, that then they read write something, that is your output. If it always spinning around, that is Turing machine doesn't hold, then we call Turing machine doesn't hold, that is unsolvable problem or undecidable problem. Okay, that is a, but that is a very fewest class of problem that I already, one problem I have told you, that is Turing halting problem. That is on the question will be the, always be there in Turing halting problem. So this is the current state. So how to make a current state? This is the symbol. If you push down automata also, you, so this is your current state. A means your current state, and this is your Q1 in the, this is not current state, A is the symbol, A is the current input symbol, and Q1 the state, and you are going to left, and now the state is, symbol is B. So you, this is a, say, Turing machine, this is A. Then you read write change, your head, right head changes to B, and it goes to left. So now your state is this. So this is a notation used by also and Turing machine also. This is input here is a, this is the input string. So A comes because it is the input, and what is the state? It is a Q1 state. Whenever it was there, the Q2 state, then it goes to, A is changed to B. So that is the reason A/B. So A/B, and it goes to left, and now the state is Q2. Okay, this is the notation. So this is replace A with B and move head left. This is the way it can be shown. It can be shown in different ways. In PDA also we will see that how the top of the stack you should mention, and current input symbol you should mention. I will show it in PDA also, the how to draw the state diagrams. Okay, I'll go with more detail. This one I have taken the book from the Michael Sipse's book. It is available. I will send you the notes. This is your finite state machine or control. This one is a finite state machine. This is an input strip. These input strips same as your FSM input strip and your pushdown automata input strip. Input strip is not to be intelligent. This is not to be intelligent. Okay, the why the power comes, say in FSM it can go only left to right. It cannot go right to left. In some other interesting way, this is a one you can assignment, that if you make your head left to right and right to left both ways in FSM, it doesn't increase the power. Okay, FSM power means it doesn't increase the understanding of the language. So so that is the reason we always make left to only left to right and no forward and reverse. Same goes for pushdown automata also. The pushdown automata becomes very powerful whenever you attach a infinite stack into it. Remember, finite state machine has, though we call finite state, but it has, can contain infinite number of states, very large number. So we don't say infinite, but however large it is, we cannot recognize a to the power n, b to the power n. But if we attach a single stack, we can get it to a to the power n, b to the power n. That is the beauty. But there also, even in the pushdown automata, there it can go from left to right, but it cannot go reverse. Okay, the head cannot move left, it can move only forward, and the head can only read, not write. Now the machine is Turing machine, the stack is not there. So one very powerful portion is taken away, but here our head is two head, basically two head combined. If you remember, if somebody's home at tape recorder, if some people have, I think you have some tape recorder, read write head in a cassette. So there in a tape you can also record a song, you can, that is, and that tape can move backward and forward. So that is the powerful of the Turing machine. It is a read write head, and it can move left and right, but it cannot move still at one place. That is the thing. We'll see what are the restriction of the Turing machine, but it's a simple machine can solve all the problems. See here, Turing machine can both write on the tape and read from it. That is great. The read-write head can move both to the left and to the right. That I have told. The tape is infinite. That is true for all machine, the tape is infinite, and the special states for rejecting and accepting state take effect immediately. This is interesting. So, in your push-down automata, you have a accepting state only. You finite state machine accepting state, but here we have a rejecting state. So, in your FSM, we have a accepting states and rejecting states. Whenever any this controls goes to rejecting states, it at once reject the input. It doesn't have to complete the string as in push-down automata or as in FSM. That is interesting. So, this is the same thing. How can you solve this? Very interesting thing. Let's go to simple that way. Say this is the W hash W. So how it is W hash W? So, this is a string 011000 and the same W is copied here and with a hash is a differentiation factor. So, we can try it with push-down automata. So, push-down automata you cannot, because whenever you push 011000 and then whenever this 0 is coming, you have to match this 0 to this 0, but you can't because your stack is this 0. You cannot match this 0 to this 0. So, push-down automata fails, I think you understand. Now, what to do in Turing machine, that is a child's play. What they do, the first place you just say one move, they just blank check whether the hash symbol is there is not. If the hash symbol is not there, it go to the rejecting state. So, because the hash symbol is not there, how can I differentiate? Okay, that is the first step. The second step is they first cross one first symbol X and they go to the next hash symbols, and if they found a 0 is there, they cross it. Okay, otherwise if they find 1, they again go to the rejecting state. Okay, now both X's is there, this is called they write it, and then it comes to 1, and then they go to here, they find it whether 1 is there. If it's found 0, it go to the rejecting state. Ultimately, whenever they are crisscrossing, all should be X's hash X's. That means then once more travel, if that computer see it is the pattern, if it is not, again goes to the reject state, otherwise it accepts state. So, this is a very fantastic examples of how to Turing machine recognize W hash W. This is very interesting example. Say this is your algorithm, this is your language. So, it will be a 0, what is the language string? Either 0 or n. When n is 0, only 1 0. When n is 1, 2 zeros. Otherwise 4 zeros. Otherwise 8 zeros, 16 zeros, 32 zeros, 128 zeros. These are the language. Language contains only one alphabet, that is 0. Either have single 0 or 2 0, 4 0, 8 0, 16 0, 32 0. This is language, because it is coming by a rule, okay, and that rule will find it out. It is definitely not deterministic context free grammar, but this is very understandable language, because you have a zeros are coming into 2 to the power this thing. How to get it, how to match it by your machine? PDA cannot. So, what we can do, by earlier logic, so we have the zeros are coming, whenever you left to right, you cut off every alternate zeros. So, if you found first 0, then second 0, you make a cross, Turing machine, then third 0, okay, fourth 0, cross. If ultimately you found it only 1 0, you accept it. If you found odd number of zeros, you go to the rejecting state. If you find the even number of zeros, again you do the same thing, 1 0 read, 1 0 cross, 1 0 read, 1 0 cross. Again you found only 1 0, you accept it. Again you found 2 0, you repeat the process. So, 1 0 card, then it will be a single 0, accept it. And if you any point of time, if you found the count of the zeros is odd, you rejected it. So, first what is should be the algorithm? One is the zeros, you first count it. Whether it is a odd, you reject it thoroughly. Then if it is even, then if you 1 0, okay, next 0 cut, 1 0, next 0 cut. So, if it is found odd, reject it. If it is found even, you again do the process. at the last process, you either have a single zero, you accept it, that's all. So this is the Turing machine can solve this kind of language. So it's very powerful language. This Turing machine is very, very powerful. So Michael Six's book is with you, and the page number I have mentioned. See, whatever the thing we discussed today, we start with the limitation of Pushdown automata. Pushdown automata is very powerful, but it cannot detect WW language or W hash W language. WW language is much more tougher. We are discussing only W hash W. So this is an interesting language, and we see in our programming language, we find certain one or two instruction can be from context sensitive grammar and all this. There, those expression may little bit about our mind, so we can accept it, but definitely 99% should be deterministic context free grammar. And what we have also discussed that in finite state machine we have said accept and reject, but here deterministic context free grammar, we not only accept and reject, we also know how the whole sentence is generated from a start symbol. That is called the parse tree, and the parse tree should be unique from the left to right parsing or right to left parsing. Left to right parsing is the top down parsing, or it is called LL1 parsing. It is much weaker, though human can understand the LL1 parsing. LR1 is a bottom up parsing. We try to match it to get it to the S, and this is more powerful. All our programming languages are basically LR1 parsing. One means one look ahead. These things we have discussed. Today we have discussed Turing machine, the very concept of Turing machine, how it can handle almost all algorithm. If Turing machine cannot solve any problem, then it is an unsolvable problem. That is the end point. Thank you all.